the past year, Maynilad has worked tirelessly towards the ultimate goal of achieving 6 million. Today, we recognize 12 of the company's employees who have served as worthy examples for the rest of us to aspire, emulate, and replicate throughout the rest of the company. We take this special opportunity to celebrate their achievements in the hopes that their passion for what they do may ripple out among all of Maynilad's ranks and challenge us all to shift gears and keep pace. Today, we present to you our 4th Maynilad Golden Meter Awards. The Golden Meter Awards are given to exemplary Maynilad employees who in the past year have exhibited extraordinary dedication and commitment in performing their duties to the highest measures of excellence, resulting in significant contributions in the overall performance of their respective departments and in fact the entire organization. Each of Maynilad's 12 divisions nominates one top-notch employee. This nominee must have implemented a measurably significant contribution to any of the 5 strategic business objectives, ensuring financial viability, improvement of organizational efficiency, operational efficiency, customer service, or the corporate image of Maynilad. Out of all the nominees, Maynilad's President and CEO, Mr. Ricky Vargas, will select 3 winners based on the following criteria: the nominee's performance in 2011, their contribution to business strategy, their attitude, and their overall leadership quality. Each of the 12 nominees will be given a special certificate of recognition and a cash prize of 10,000 pesos. Our 3 Golden Meter Award winners will each receive 50,000 pesos and a prestigious Golden Meter Trophy. First nominee contributed to the smooth transition during the outsourcing period by providing support in the knowledge transfer needed for the transition to the source team. She also acted as a de facto operations head in ensuring smooth operations in all the ITS areas during the transition. She standardized an MS project template for monitoring projects with all the necessary PMP metrics automatically calculated. From IT services, the head for operations and projects, Zenaida Bautista. Our next nominee was instrumental in completing all Maynilad requirements to draw on the first tranche of the 7 billion peso facility loan before the end of March 2011. She was heavily involved with the coordination of all register of deeds where Maynilad facilities are located and the negotiation with the concerned parties. She served as chief coordinator working with our sewerage and environmental groups as well as their counterparts in the World Bank and Land Bank, enabling us to obtain the NEDA, BSP, and DOF approvals for the loan. From Finance Division, Head of Treasury, Aurora Canape, CPA. Next nominee took the lead in forging new business relationships across the nation by coordinating with the various water districts, local government units, and private water service providers. He was instrumental in laying the groundwork for the Maynilad expansion activities in the cities and provinces outside Metro Manila. He also made sure that the joint venture between Maynilad and Manila Water is put into place and set into motion for 2012. He also took the initiative to bring to Maynilad potential business opportunities outside the West Zone whenever they arise. Our corporate attorney from Legal and Regulatory Affairs, Attorney Ronnie Ray Paraiso. Through the leadership of our next nominee, his team has completed the inventory of the mainline appurtenances in proposed strategic locations and installed 32 new primary valves. He also initiated the plans and actual implementation of aggressive works in energizing the primary lines along Marcos Alvarez Las Piñas. He also led the continuous development of our engineers' technical expertise on PRVs at par with world-class technical experts. He also led the study on improving the efficiencies of our La Mesa treatment plants. The concurrent head of water production and primary network operations and maintenance from water supply operations and program management, Engineer Greg Antonio. Nominee introduced a new way of telemetry communication system from radio-based to a cellular-based monitoring system. He spearheaded the automation group for Maynila and established the telemetry system for treatment plants, pumping stations, and reservoirs. He created the architecture of the new telemetry system, which addresses the issues on technology advancement and system compatibilities. Through research and development, his team created a data logging system that is more convenient and cost-efficient. The head of telemetry from the Technical Services Division, Engineer Almeida Almazay. Our next nominee contributed in the design, preparation, and review of bid documents and the evaluation of sewerage treatment plants of ongoing sewerage projects. With his help, 12 STPs in the San Juan River Basin project are now being implemented without the assistance of outside consultants. Our next nominee also conceptualized the knowledge and data management system for the division, which is now in its initial stage of implementation. He also took the lead in drafting policies for their division, including design criteria and effluent standards policies, among others. From Wastewater Management Division, the Head of Planning, Information, and Resource Management, Engineer Ryan Aurelio. Through the leadership and initiatives of our next nominee, the improvement and enhancement of the Maynilad meter testing facility was done with a more comprehensive analysis of meter performance. This saves Maynilad 1.5 million pesos a year in testing fees. The testing of meters alone has generated 5 million pesos for IMM for the past 2 years. Our next nominee also developed the special gate and ball valve, or the G-spring valve, which helps to further improve the CMD. He also spearheaded the automated meter reading technology through data logging equipment and GPRS communication for DMA meter, large account meter, and small meters. He also developed the concept design for the instrumentation box for data logger, meter converter, and pressure reducing valve. The head of integrated meter management from Central Non-Revenue Water, Engineer Jonahil Ascan. Next nominee facilitated the advanced MSA installation to the fourth power, which helped in the marketing efforts because almost all potential customers pay the initial payment in advance. This enhancement of the water service connection application process resulted in a high turnout of applicants even prior to the energizing of the CapEx projects. Our next nominee served as a catalyst in enabling operating units to pursue new ways of handling the expansion projects in Las Piñas and Cavite. To date, the Cavite-Las Piñas business area has accumulated miscellaneous collection of 106.41 million pesos from the paid applications gathered. From business area operations, the head of the Cavite-Las Piñas business area, Engineer Nestor Divinagracia. The leadership of our next nominee, his team managed to increase the health and fitness awareness among Maynilad's employees. By managing HMO concerns, he was able to reduce the HMO utilization cost by 8.4% from 2010. Through this, Maynilad was able to save 8 million pesos without compromising quality service. His team was also able to install the first Maynilad pharmacy in the main office and Aroseros. The head of health management from Corporate Human Capital and Organization Development, Dr. Ricardo Jose Miranda. Under the leadership of our next nominee, the number of accredited vendors for supplies, materials, and equipment and services of Maynilad has substantially increased. Through this, Maynilad has been able to get better prices, thus effectively lowering its costs and expenses. Together with the inventory control section of the department, her office helped in substantially bringing down Maynilad's excessive inventory by more than half from 1.73 billion in December 2010 to only 655 million by the end of December 2011. Concurrent head for Vendor and Product Evaluation Materials Planning and Control Department and Forecast Management Materials Planning and Control Department from Corporate Logistics, Estrelita Gravides. Next nominee actively pursued the formulation and implementation of the Maynilad Safety Code, attaining an all-time high of 7 million man-hours no lost time accident. He also formulated and implemented 25 different environmental safety and health work procedures and guidelines, keeping work sites free from accidents and illnesses. He also conducted and spearheaded numerous safety and health trainings for Maynilad employees and contractors. Our next nominee contributed significantly in enhancing the corporate image of Maynilad through his contribution in the certification of the North Caloocan Business Area in ISO 9001, ISO 14001, and OHSAS 18001. From quality, environment, safety, and health, Maynilad's head for safety, Engineer Conrad Soriano. Through the leadership of our next nominee, his department was able to achieve a collection efficiency of 104% from June to December 2011 and reduced accounts receivable by 8.2 million pesos. He also spearheaded the negotiations and implementation of the Maynilad Tex Tubig and conceptualized the After the Meter project. He is also the man behind the Customer Service Idol project. From Commercial and Marketing, the Head of Relationship Management, Carlo Comstein. Water meter is familiar to all of us because it is at the core of Maynilad's business. With this instrument, we are able to measure how much water is delivered to our customers. Sa bawat paggalaw ng metro, may tubig na dumadaloy. At habang dumadaloy ang tubig, may mga empleyadong nagtatrabaho ng mahusay upang tiyakin na ang tubig ay darating kung kailan at kung saan ito kinakailangan. The passionate and hard-working employees of Maynilad continue to work hard to make sure that the meters do not stop moving and that the water does not stop flowing. While all of Maynilad's employees contribute to the reliable delivery of water, there are a few exceptional employees that choose to go beyond the expectations of their stakeholders. Tonight, we gather together to honor them and celebrate their outstanding contributions.